Hello children, welcome to our science session. In today's session, let's start revising chapter 16, light. We have learned that what is light? Light is a form of energy that enables us to see around us. So what is light? Light is a form of energy that enables us to see around us, or we can say that light is an electromagnetic wave that can travel through medium as well as through vacuum. So any both the answer you can write. So what is light? Light is a form of energy that enables us to see around us, and it is an electromagnetic wave that can travel through medium as well as through vacuum, that is without medium. Then how do we see objects? Our eyes alone do not allow us to see. So for seeing object, what is essential? Light is essential. So light from a source falls on an object, and then it reflects back, bounces back and reaches our eyes. And that is how we can see object. That is how we perceive the object, perceive it. So how do we see objects? For seeing, our eyes alone do not allow us to see any object around us. Light from a source falls on an object and then bounces off, bounces back and reaches our eyes, and that is how we perceive it. Then we have learned there are two types of objects, luminous objects and non-luminous objects. So what are luminous objects? Luminous objects are those objects which has its own light. What are luminous objects? Luminous objects are those objects which can produce or which has its own light. And non-luminous objects, what are non-luminous objects? Non-luminous objects are those objects which do not has its own light. So you can tell that non-luminous object as illuminated object also. Once again, luminous objects are those objects which can produce light on their own. Example, you can tell tube light, bulb, sun, stars, etc. And non-luminous objects are otherwise called as illuminated objects. Illuminated objects are also called as non-luminous objects. Non-luminous objects are illuminated objects, or objects that do not produce light on their own but reflect the light that falls upon them are called illuminated object. For example, moon. Now when when light falls on any surface, actually what happens when light falls on any surface? Either of the following phenomenon takes place. First, when light falls, light falling on a surface may get absorbed, or light falling on a surface may pass through the surface. Thirdly, when a light falls on a surface may bounce back. So among these three, any one phenomenon may take place. So when light falls on a surface, what happens? It may get absorbed, or it may pass through the surface, or it get bounced back. And this bouncing back of light rays after it strike the surface is called as reflection. Okay children, now what is reflection of light? When the light falls on a surface, it get bounced back. So this bouncing back of light rays on striking the surface is called as reflection of light, or called as reflection. And which object is a best reflector? So what are the characteristics of best reflector? The best reflector, that is in order to reflect the light back, the object, that surface should have shiny surface, or it should have polished surface, or it should have smooth surface. So what are the characteristics of best reflector? The best reflector should have shiny surface, it should have polished surface, or it should have smooth surface. silver metal is the best reflector. We can see silver, gold, and all they shines because they have shiny surface or polished surface. Now, next, what happens when light falls on a mirror? So, when a light falls on a mirror, what happens? We know that light is a form of energy which enables us to see, or which is responsible for sense of sight for us in human eyes. So light can also be called as radiation, that is emitted or reflected or absorbed by different objects. So that now we have revised this. So what happens when light falls on any surface? Either it will be absorbed, or it will be emitted, or it will be reflected back. Emitted means which pass through, or it will be reflected. So mirror, if you take, it is a glass having shiny surface. So when a light falls on a mirror, it is reflected back. Hence, the mirror changes the direction of light falls upon it. So what happens when light falls on a mirror? Mirror, as it is a glass having shiny surface. When a light falls on the mirror, the light is reflected back. Hence, a mirror changes the direction of light that falls upon it. Now, let's revise about laws of reflection. And before that, what is reflection of light? So what is reflection of light? When a light strikes a surface, it gets bounces back. This bouncing back of light is called as reflection of light. And on laws of reflection, for that, if you have to know these following definition. What is incident ray? That is, the ray of light that falls on the surface is called as incident ray. Now, children, what is incident ray? The ray of light that falls on the surface is called as incident ray. Then what is reflected ray? The ray of light that gets reflected back from the surface is called reflected ray. After the light gets strike the surface, it reflected back. So the ray of light that gets reflected back from the surface is called as reflected ray. And what is normal? Normal is an imaginary line that is drawn perpendicular to the reflecting surface at the point where incident rays strike the surface, or you can tell, or at the point of incidence. So what is normal? Normal is an imaginary line that is drawn. It is an imaginary perpendicular line to the reflecting surface at the point of incidence. You can write this shortly also. What is normal? Normal is an imaginary line or imaginary line that is drawn perpendicular to the reflecting surface at the point of incidence. Now, what is angle of incidence? Angle of incidence is the angle between the incident ray with the normal. So between incident ray and normal, you can have one angle. That angle is called as angle of incidence. So what is angle of incidence? Angle of incidence is the angle between incident ray with the normal. What is angle of reflection? Angle of reflection is an angle that forms between the reflected ray with the normal. And for any incident ray, always there will be one reflected ray. And after striking the mirror, the ray of light is reflected in another direction. So the light ray which strikes the surface, what we call that as incident ray, and the ray that comes back from the surface after reflection is known as reflected ray. So this incident ray and reflected ray. So the light ray which strikes the surface is called as incident ray, and the ray that comes back from the surface after reflection is known as reflected ray. And here if you see, the angle of figure is very important. Angle of the relation between the angle of incidence and angle of reflection. So if you see the relation between angle of incidence and angle of reflection, they are approximately equal. Or we can say that the angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. This is known as law of reflection. So what is the relation between angle of incidence and angle of reflection? You should know that angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. Now, first law of reflection. Law of reflection, we have first law of reflection is the angle of incidence and the angle of reflection are always equal to each other. Or we can tell the angle by which a ray of light is incident on a surface will always be equal to the angle by which it is reflected back from the surface. This is first law of reflection. What is first law of reflection? The angle of incidence and angle of reflection are always equal. And what is second law of reflection? The incident ray, the normal. Normal means where at the point of incidence. And the reflected ray all lie in the same plane. This is called as second law of reflection. Now, children, what is second law of reflection of light? The incident ray, the normal at the point of incidence, and the reflected ray all lie in the same plane. Okay, children, so what two laws of reflection what we have learned, you should know is first law of reflection is the angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. And second law states that incident ray, reflected ray and the normal at the point of incidence to the reflecting surface lie in the same plane. So these are laws of reflection. Okay, children, that's all for this session. We will be continuing revision of this chapter in a next session.